Welcome everyone, this is the game between the Indian prodigy Pragnananda and he takes on Levon Babugian, a strong grandmaster from Armenia. Prag opens the game with knight f3 and Babugian plays the classical d5. Prag now hits the center with c4 and Babugian takes the pawn. Knight to a3 attacking the pawn, and black has to decide how is he going to defend it. Babugian decides to just fianchetto to his bishop and give up the pawn. Prag now has a very nice setup in the English. He plays bishop d2. Notice how he doesn't develop his bishop on f1, because Prag sees that he can now push his pawn b4, b5. By making this move, Prag is looking a little bit distracted. He's just seeing here and there. Also shows a bit of confidence that he likes his position. Knight g to e7. Now the natural move is bishop g2, fianchettoing, but b4 in the position, and Babugian just plays a6, stopping b5. Rook comes to c1 and short castles. Prag now goes bishop g2, and white is going to now short castle in this position. But first a3, protecting the pawn. Black has a very nice queenside space. White has a very nice queenside space in the position, and now castles by Prag. Generally in this setup you want to put pressure on black's queenside, and Prag has already managed to do that a bit with his knight on c4, rook on c1, pawn on b4. So Babugian is a bit tied up. He's thinking on how he should continue. He plays his king to h7 and now a4. The idea now is to push b5 so that black gets even more space on the queen side. This is something that Babugian does not want. He pushes his pawn to b5, and now Prag is instantly ready with knight a5. You can see that Pragnananda has just used 5 seconds on his clock, while Babugian is down to 2 minutes. The knight on a5 is beautifully placed. It's putting pressure on the knight on c6. Notice the bishop on g2 is eyeing that long diagonal. So black has to tread carefully. If he takes on a5, white gets a passer with the bishop defending it. He takes it, pawn takes a5, and Prag has now a dangerous passed pawn. Also, the c7 pawn is a bit of a weakness. You can see that Prag is looking into the camera here, but he's still thinking about his move. Many times chess players are not focusing on the board but are still thinking about what their next move ought to be. Knight to d5 has been played here. Maybe the plan is to push the pawn to b4 and then the a5 pawn would become weak. Prag pushes e4 and Babugian goes back. His point is now the d3 pawn is slightly weak. The rook moves into c5. Now he's zooming in a bit on the board. The rook on c5 is putting pressure on the b5 pawn. Prag has managed to stabilize the position. Now the rook comes to a6. You could take the pawn on b5, but right now queen c2 is such a strong move because you're putting pressure on the c7 pawn, and also b5 pawn is hanging. So Babugian now is thinking about moving his queen, but then decides against it. You can see how Prag has only used 22 seconds while Babugian is down to his last 50 seconds. Bishop d7. This sets up a very sly trap, because if Prag takes the pawn on c7, then knight c6 attacks the bishop on b4, and also the rook on c7 is trapped. So that is a very nice trap by Babugian in this position, and Prag sees it. He takes the pawn on e5, bishop e5, rook e5, knight c6. Prag is now a pawn up, but his bishop on b4 is hanging, and also the pawn on a5. But he can just pull back his bishop, and black cannot yet take the pawn on a5 because the c7 pawn would be hanging. Prag taking his time. He has the liberty now to take a bit of time because he has managed his time so well until now. White is a pawn up. Even though black can win the pawn on a5 at some point, it will still give white a very, very good advantage. Prag moves his bishop back to d2, waiting for Babujian's response now. A very logical idea would be to push the pawn to b4, which he does. And now rook takes a5 is the threat, so that the pawns are at least equalized. Now Prag has to decide, because he can't cling on to the pawn on a5. It is attacked twice. Should he go rook a1, trying to defend that pawn? Should he go queen c5? There are many, many possibilities in the position. But now Pragnananda using so much time in the last two moves that he is also coming down towards 1 minute. Babujian looks very, very confident in the screen. Prag goes queen to c4, attacking the rook. And now rook takes a5, pawn to d4. With this, the central pawns start to roll. Notice how d5 is a possibility. Also e5. Also the pawn on f7 is slightly weak. White's position is beautiful. And black is in big trouble. Babujian has to decide how to continue. He goes rook a4 to protect his pawn on b4. And now Prag can simply push the pawn to d5 and win the pawn on c7 with his queen. Just relaxing a bit. You can see how Pragnananda is totally relaxed here. I mean, generally when you are down to 1 minute, you are leaning on the board. You want to find the moves. But Prag knows that he's got this. All he needs to do is keep his calm and calculate all the variations accurately. Now he leans in. Just a final bit of calculation. Both are down to 30 seconds. Pawn to d5 takes the pawn on c7, and now b3 has been pushed. Now the b pawn can be dangerous. White is a pawn up still. Prag plays his bishop to c4 and rook c4. Oh my god, that's a piece blunder. And you can see how Babujian has noticed that that's a blunder. He thought he was winning a piece, but in fact he missed that the knight on e5 was hanging. And after queen takes, bishop takes, it's just a complete piece down. He's shaking his head in disbelief. What has he just done? 17 seconds on the clock, but nothing to be done here. He stops the clock, shakes hands, and Pragnananda has won.